Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God Almighty, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the scroll of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Now, Israel, obey the laws and customs that I teach you today. If you obey, you will have life, and you will have the land of God will give you. You will not add anything to the laws that I give you, and you must not take away anything from the laws. You must obey and keep the commandments that I give you from the Lord your God. Respect and obey the laws. Show other people your wisdom and understanding. When they know and begin to understand God's laws, they will say, 'The people of Israel, he is always ready to help when we ask him.' Other countries do not have laws and customs as great as ours. I, Moses, give you these laws and customs from the Lord our God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response is, Lord, who can go into your tent? Response, Lord, who can go into your tent? Lord, who can live on your holy mountain? A person with no sin? A person that does things fairly and tells the truth from his heart? Response, Lord, who can go into your tent? Lord, who can live on your holy mountain? A person that does not hurt brother or sister? A person that lends things without charging interest? A person that does not fiddle with money? Response, Lord, who can go into your tent? Lord, who can live on your holy mountain? A person that always honours and respects the Lord? A person that is faithful forever? That person can live on your holy mountain forever. Response, Lord, who can go into your tent? A reading from the letter of St. James. All good things are from heaven. All gifts are from God. God is the Father, creator of all light. There is no darkness in God. There is no shadow. God does not change. It was God's choice that we become his children by the message of truth, so that we become important in his created world. Be humble and accept the word that God has planted in you. This teaching will save you. Do not listen and do nothing. If you only listen and think you obey God, this will not help you. You must listen and follow God's word. God, our Father, wants you to look after those children that have no parents. Support the widows when they need help. And keep yourself pure from the world's evil influence. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be
to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Lord, your words are spirit. Your words have life. You have the message of eternal life. Alleluia.
Some Pharisees and scribes came from Jerusalem and gathered around Jesus. They saw some of Jesus' disciples were eating with dirty hands. They did not wash their hands. The Pharisees and the Jews never ate before washing their hands. They followed the Jewish tradition and always washed their hands up to the elbow. Also, after they come back from the marketplace, they always sprinkle water on themselves. They have many other rules, how to wash cups, pots, and bronze dishes. So the Pharisees and scribes asked Jesus, "Why do your disciples not respect the Jewish tradition, but eat with dirty hands?" Jesus answered, "You are all hypocrites. Isaiah was right about you when he prophesied in the scripture. These people say they honor God, but their hearts are really far away from the worship they give to me is false. They teach others using their rules, and they say that their rules are the same as God's laws. You forget God's laws, and you follow your own rules and your own traditions." Jesus continued and said to the people, "Listen to me, all. You must understand that if a person eats something, that food cannot make the person bad or wrong. No, it is the things a person says from within that make the person bad or wrong. Evil things come from the heart, like adultery, fornication, theft, murder."
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So the scribes and the Pharisees were the religious leaders of Israel. The Pharisees fought, and the scribes were the experts in the scriptures. However, Jesus said that they were breaking the Ten Commandments themselves. They were breaking God. the law of God became distorted. They began to look down on others and would not have anything to do with them. They taught other people to do the same. For example, the Jews would not do anything with the Samaritans. Same can be said about all the rules about washing themselves and things. This did not simply have to do with hygiene. This was part of the ritual cleanliness, the extra rules that would be made. Jesus told his apostles why the Pharisees and scribes were wrong. And then, a pagan woman came to Jesus and wanted him to help her daughter. Jesus responded like the Pharisees and scribes. First, he did not answer and walked away. The woman loved her daughter very much, and she answered Jesus with honesty and faith.
for Pope Francis and all the leaders in our church, that they will help us to appreciate all the gifts which come from God. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer. We pray for our leaders in Australia and throughout the world, that they will use their authority and power in ways that show compassion for poor and vulnerable people. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer. For our parish community and our deaf community, that we will always be a loving community, united in faith and the desire to serve each other in the name of Christ. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer. We pray for people who are sick and those who care for them. Gentle God, give them your comfort and love and help to ease their suffering. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer. We pray for all people who suffer from the impacts of COVID. Lord, give strength to your people in these challenging times. Look upon us, your children, and protect us in this difficult time. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer. We pray for our brothers and sisters who have died, and that they will live forever in the peace of Christ in the kingdom of heaven. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer.
Blessed are you, O God, all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice into your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift our hearts to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy God, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world, that in mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation of your faith. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holies. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink of it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery.
We proclaim
the death of the Lord and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Anthony our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Michael Issa, whom you have called from this world to your servant. Grant that he who is united with your Son in death like this may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
and with your spirit.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Just a short announcement. Be safe, be healthy. See you next week. Thank you for watching.